They are failing the test of duty to the Australian people, and they do it trying to kid themselves that this is being done in the name of humanitarianism.
You've probably heard about Medevac by now. It's the bill that almost brought down government in February. So what is this bill, and why is it so damn controversial?
In fact, this bill and our amendments are about Australia's character. It's about how we treat sick people in our care.
The Medevac bill makes it easier for sick refugees and asylum seekers to receive healthcare in Australia. If a person being detained on Manus or Nauru is sick, two doctors must recommend that that person be temporarily transferred to Australia. Then, Minister Peter Dutton has 3 days to approve or deny the request. Since its inception, the government has been desperately trying to repeal the legislation, but has faced a few hiccups. The first concerns the approval process. Peter Dutton has the power to deny an application for 3 reasons. 1, if he believes a medical transfer is unnecessary for treatment. 2, if there is a national security concern. Or 3, if the person has a criminal record and there is a risk of criminal conduct. If a request is denied for medical reasons, the decision is referred to an independent health advice panel and reviewed by a panel of medical experts who can make recommendations to the minister.
The Medevac bill is working. It is saving lives. It is getting desperately ill people to Australia.
If refused for national security reasons, the case can be referred to the federal court. On the one hand, the bill aims to create a process that focuses on treatment, giving medical experts more input instead of leaving it to politicians and bureaucrats. But obviously, the government would prefer to be in complete control.
How bad it is for a government to be compelled to bring somebody to our country when we're worried about their criminal history, we're worried about their character.
Second, when the bill was first introduced, the medical evacuee was required to have a direct personal interaction with the doctor who recommended the transfer, either a phone call or a teleconference. The federal court has recently ruled that asylum seekers can be medically transferred based on medical records and test results, with the recommendation of 2 doctors.
What this does is it changes how someone who is a person on Nauru can trigger the Medevac process. What it does not do is change anything when it comes to the minister's discretion and power.
The decision aims to open transfers to asylum seekers on Nauru who could not previously access the teleconference process. But some are angry at what they see as a weakening of the laws.
This legislation is unnecessary. It's legislation that weakens the control that the government has over these decisions.
This setback comes as the government considers whether to force a vote to repeal Medevac laws in the final parliamentary sitting of the year. The fate of the legislation currently lies with Senator Jackie Lambie, whose support rests on a mysterious condition that she says must be met before she offers her backing.